Good morning. In this video, I want to present a thesis about machine learning, in particular about artificial neural network applied to the context of industrial automation and, in particular, on industrial communication. So, the idea is of this thesis is given the path of a wireless channel, so given the quality in terms of packet that can deliver it without error to the destination of a Wi-Fi channel, we want to predict the future. So we want to know the behavior of this Wi-Fi channel in the near future. This is really important from an application point of view because we can use this information in order to modify the way the application uses the Wi-Fi channel in order to meet some constraints. For instance, in the context of industrial automation, you have, for instance, to move a robotic arm in order to do a work or something like this. If the packet does not arrive to the destination within a given deadline, we have the problem that we fall the products and we have many more important problems related to safety. So if we know that in the future we will have some problem on the communication, we can, for instance, remove some useless communication or decide to switch to another channel that is in some way better. After this first introduction, I want to go a little bit more in detail, so I will switch to this view in order to know which is the most important points of this thesis. In order to go in deep on the most important points, I need to contextualize a little bit how we obtain the data and so on. So in particular, as you know, when we use a machine learning algorithm, the most important things is the database that, for instance, was already acquired. In particular, we acquired a database with a length 5 months. So we have a bigger database in order to analyze and to try to optimize this algorithm. So in particular, the idea is this one. We have a PC. This PC is equipped with a Wi-Fi network adapter, this one. We have an access point. So the real setup is more complex, but we start with this one. And the idea is that for the acquisition of this database, we cyclically every half a second generated a packet, a UDP packet directed to the access point. So this is our packet. As you know, in all the wireless communication, in order to notify the sender node that the packet is correctly delivered to the recipient, there is the generation of an acknowledge frame in the opposite direction. So the idea is that we modified the driver of the network adapter of this PC, and in particular we do many modifications. For instance, we disable automatic retransmission of frame, but are details. So the idea is that inside this PC we can obtain many features, many characteristics related to this Wi-Fi channel. In particular, for each packet, we log the time on which the packet was sent, the time on which the packet arrived to the sender node, and this way we can obtain the so-called latency. That is TF minus TS. Then we log another really important thing, the fact if the packet arrived or not. So 0 is if there is a loss of the packet and 1 if the packet arrived. And then we log many other information, for instance, the RSSI of the acknowledge frame, that is the received signal strength indicator, that has an important meaning because identify the power of the signal of the arrived of this ACK frame. So the idea we log all these things for four or five months. Actually, we have a different separate database because we have not the possibility to run an experiment of 5 months, but we have some hole in between. And we obtain four database, one for each different channel of Wi-Fi. So in particular, we obtain 5 months of database for Wi-Fi channel 1, 5 months for Wi-Fi channel 5, 5 months for Wi-Fi channel 9, and 5 months for the channel 13. So this is our base on which we train a neural network model. So basically, the idea is that given an input to our neural network, an input that correspond to the frame of the past. So the idea is that in an application, when the application runs, takes the last frames. For instance, in this case, we take, depending on the experiment, 30 minutes or 1 hour. Okay, so starting from our database, we can obtain with a sliding windows these things that correspond, given a given time t, to the last, to the previous packets that represent the past characteristic of our channel. Then, since we know the future, we can also obtain which is the quality of the channel in the future. In particular, we did many experiments, but for instance, we have a publication, a really recent publication, related on the next 30 minutes. So the idea is that here we have an evolution of the channel quality. For instance, we pass for the 80%, then we go to the 50%, then we return to a good behavior. So 90% means that only one packet every 10 packets is lost, so it's a good channel. And the idea is that at each time we use on the node a neural network in order to predict which is the future, let me know the future quality of this channel. For instance, if we have a prediction of 30%, this means that the channel will fall in a bad behavior. Instead, if we have a prediction of 95%, we can say that the channel remains stable into a good quality. It was a bet because at the beginning we don't know if we can really predict the future. So actually the idea is that we try, and yes, given really easy feature, for instance, in this case, our feature are 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, and so on. That means if the packet at time t minus 1 arrived, in this case it does not arrive. If the packet at time t minus 2 arrived, in this case it arrived, and so on, we can predict with a not so bad quality the future evolution of the channel. So the idea is that in the training, in the test phase, we provide this vector in input this vector is generated by a front-end module. So basically the front-end module, given the database I speak before, generate a vector like this, or a more complex vector with some elaboration, with some other feature. In any case, this vector, that is this one, is the input of our neural network. So we train a neural network, and at the end, after the training, this neural network will predict the behavior of the channel in the next 30 minutes. So for instance, the neural network predict 25%. If the real error of the channel in the next 30 minutes is 30%, and we can obtain it because we know it from the database, We can conclude that this error network has an error in this case of 5% in order to assess the quality of the channel. We start with a really easy model that is a small neural network. We use as platform Colab, that is a platform provided by Google in order that allow to write machine learning algorithms. As library we use Keras and Pandas for some things. So at the end, all these library are programmed in Python. And so we make using Colab in Python our program in order to analyze the possibility of predicting the future. So at the end, the thesis will be done in any case using the Python language and using this library. Actually, remember that in any thesis you have a part of the first months in which you learn the problem you study. Then you have 3 4 months, better 4 months, in which you have you can work and you can proceed with your thesis. You have here an overlapped part from the that is about 1.5 months, in which you have to write your thesis. And at the end, the total length of the thesis is more or less 6 months. So, in my point of view, it is 6 months can arrive to 7, but not more to 7, because it's good that you have in mind that it is a work, you have to dedicate a big part of your time of this work, but the time is bounded. So the idea is that if you dedicate, there are many video about how I intend a thesis, but in any case, if you dedicate 6 months of the thesis, not all the day, but for instance, 4 days, over 5 days, and so on, in this period you must arrive to the finish of your thesis. As I said, a little bit digression, the thesis for my point of view is a work that was done in conjunction with me and with the other correlator. So the idea is that we can keep in contact all the days in order to know how the thesis proceed and to try to solve the problem you can found all the day, because I think this is important, because in some way there is an exchange of information between the students and the teacher. So this is a really important point. Another important point is for me is that you have an average greater or equal to 27. Okay, so this is not a strict threshold, so depends, can be also a small score, but we can to discuss. But in any case, a good average, and you have one. True, but it's better one left exam or zero left exam, because I think it is good for you that when you do the thesis, you dedicate most of the time of the thesis, because I think it's also important, because it's the step that is in the meanwhile from the study to the work. So it's good that you concentrate yourself. Actually, some of you then will go on with PhD or remain in research, but depends. So here you have a piece of our code in Keras, scoring Google Colab, but not important. As you see, here you have the Python programming language. For instance, in this case, we train a model that is composed of sigmoid functions. We have a network of one hidden layer of this dimension, only one output layer, this, the learning rate, and so on. But in the case, it's not important for me that you know exactly also. There is the first month in which you have to learn how it works, but you know that in neural network the idea is that you provide an example that is the input vector I show you. You provide the target that is what do you want to attain, in our case, the frame loss probability. And the idea is that providing this example, we obtain an output. The output has an error. So with the backpropagation process, the neural network training algorithm correct the weights of your neural network and decrease the error. So the term epochs means each time we cycle on the training database. So we have a training database that consists, for instance, of 4 months, a test database that consists of 1 month that is the correlated for the training database. One epoch is when we train, we pass all our training database. So in this case, to train this neural network, we use really many epochs, 20, 30 epochs. And this means that we cycle 30 times on the training database, and the idea is that, as you can see, this loss is the performance of the neural network, in particular the error of the neural network. As you can see, when we proceed in the training, this value decreases. In the meanwhile, we decide in this training that at each epoch we decrease the learning rate, but are details. The learning rate is basically how much we change the weight of the neural network when we have an error. So the idea is that at the beginning we change too much this weight, and after time passes, we decrease the amount, the delta on which we change this weight in order to freeze your network on a good working point. Okay, this is basically the working platform. Actually, we use in some part, we use all the Linux operating system, but practically all the algorithm is implemented on this platform. We have many things to do. So basically, the first things to do is to try to use recurrent neural network that are network that I use for series analysis, because it is known that they work better to predict time series. So recurrent neural network are the network that are used, for instance, to predict the definiance, devolution of a stock in the future or something like this. So the first things to do in this thesis is to analyze recurrent neural network. Then there are many other interesting things to do that are first of all to analyze other features. So I say to you that we have other features that are latency, that are RSSI. So at the end, we have to add this feature in our input vector and analyze if the impact is positive or not. We have also other ideas. In particular, we have ideas of architecture. Ideas. Now we are using a neural network with only one output. We want to pass to neural network that makes use more than one output. For instance, not to predict only 30 minutes as future evolution, but to predict also 1 minute and so on. So there is a lot of work, but The first important things for you is that first of all I have to learn recurrent neural network and to learn how to train neural network on a pretty modern platform that is Colab, and you can manage on real neural network. Second, first important things is that in this stage you will use real data because many scientific works related to artificial neural network make use of artificial data, and so the game is easiest with artificial data, but there are less that they have a less meaning than the artificial one. Okay, so these are the main point I want to analyze in this thesis. I don't know if we have the possibility to analyze all, but at least recurrent neural network and one new feature I think is a good target for a possible thesis. If you want to ottain more information, remember that in the website scans.it/ss you have all the description related to myself, so you can see what is my main research topic. Also here in the research folder you have some of my experience, but more important, if you go in the publication tab you have a link to this scientific article that has title Predicting Wi-Fi Link Quality Through Artificial Neural Network. If you click here, you will be redirected to the page of this article. And so, first of all, if you click on PDF, you can download the article. It is open, so you can download it. As you can see, this article is in accepted stage. This means that it is accepted, but it is not finished the complete publication because it needs time. But in any case, it is practically the definite form of this article. The only things that will be done at the end on the final part of publication is a correction from an English people of the grammar of the English part, but we think is pretty not so bad. So why it is important this article? Because at the end this is the first article related to the setup I show you. I did this article with this student that I say thank you because is my thesis that did the first part of this thesis. So we reach a good goal, I think, to have an article during a thesis. In any case, we can go on. Here we have a description of the architecture we use. In any case, if you are interested, we have a more accurate description in the sense that we can have in the next 15 ma in the next months we can have the thesis of the students, but in any case here you have the description of the mathematical formulation, but it's not so complex, but I'm not going into details. Here you see you have this part that is the past, this other part that is the future, that is the target. Here there is the description on how we starting from 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, that is the behavior of the network, we can obtain the feature of our model. This is an interesting point because here I can enlarge a little bit. You can see for a specific database the evolution of the channel during time. So here you have 16 days, and as you can see, there are some parts in which the channel goes in a not good way, So in this case, only 60% of the packet arrive correct to the destination, and we have some part on which it works in a good way. Here you have another part of the dataset, you have a description of the experimental we did, and here you have some result. I don't know, but you can see we compare our artificial neural network model with different parametrization with a method based on a moving average, and as you can see we win in many times if we compare our performance with this model. Okay, thanks. I pretty finish my explanation. There are really many things to say, to speak about. No problem. If you have any question, you can contact me by mail, by Telegram, and we can manage a meeting. So for any question, feel free to contact myself. Thank you very much. Bye bye.